Why in the world would you take out her uterus? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is not going to be long, it's going to be really really short. I just needed to film about this topic. Let me just read you the topic first. A woman in South Africa claims she was sterilized without her consent after she gave birth at the age of 17 and only learned about it 11 years later when she tried to have another child. Wongel Zelalem was among 48 women sterilized without consent at state hospitals, the Commission of Gender Equality found. Despite being a statutory body, the commission said its inquiry was hampered by the disappearance of patients' files and its investigators had received a hostile reception from hospital staff. Ms. Msebe recalled her ordeal. I woke up after giving birth, looked down and asked, "Why do I have a huge bandage on my stomach?" I did not mind. I had just given birth to my baby daughter. She was a big baby. I left hospital 5 days after giving birth with a healthy baby daughter and a huge scar across my stomach. I did not find out what had really happened for another 11 years. Things unraveled when I was trying to conceive again. I had been taking the contraceptive pill for that whole time since I had given birth, and so it was not strange that I had not had my period. But I got engaged and wanted to have another baby, so I went to the doctor. He examined me, sat me down, gave me a glass of water and told me I had no uterus. It is very cruel. I was devastated and confused. It did not make sense because I was already a mother. I worked out, my uterus must have been removed, and the only time it could have happened was after I had given birth. It is very cruel what they did to me. I went to the press, then the health ministry, and eventually ended up back at the hospital where I gave birth with the doctor who said he was there that day. He did not say sorry. He told me that he had sterilized me in order to save my life. I still do not know what he was trying to save me from. There are no records at the hospital. I am not the only one. An inquiry has found there are 47 others. Some were told it was because they had HIV, but I do not. I just don't know why they did it. The doctor told me that I had signed a consent form. I had not. I was a minor at the time, so would not have been able to. The news changed my life. In the end, I split up with my fiance. I had to let him go because he really wanted children and I could not give him that. When I met the doctor, I was asked what I want. I want a baby so badly. Still have ovaries, and so I think the hospital should pay for a surrogate. And I also want somebody to be held accountable. And then I want the doctor who did this to say he is sorry. How are they not taking accountability for this? How is the doctor not saying sorry? And how is he saving her life by taking out her uterus after she gave birth? Like, how does that make sense to you? Like, I am very confused. Why do you need to take somebody else's uterus out to save their life as a doctor after giving birth? Like, I have no idea what they needed to do that. And it's not just her. There are 48 more cases like that. And this is really ridiculous because this reminds me of a documentary I've watched back in the days about how they sterilize the black community, how they make sure that they give us birth controls. And then when you want a baby and then you leave the birth control alone to try and conceive, then you can't. You try. Like, I've heard so many stories. Even in Ethiopia, I've heard a lot of stories when it comes to this. Like, women will have, they'll use a contraceptive, like other than condom, maybe like the one that they put inside your arms, the hormonal ones. They'll take it, they'll take the pills, and then when they decide now they want to have a baby and they take it out and they're trying for a baby, it never happens. They try for 5 years plus, 10 years, they haven't been able to. I thought this contraceptive method is for a temporary. They tell us it's for 2 years, they tell us it's for a year, they tell us as soon as you take it out you're able to conceive. But how come it doesn't happen? How come people are struggling? How come women are not able to give birth when they want to, have baby conceive when they want to? So this has been on my mind for a while now because of the stories I've heard and the documentaries I've watched when it comes to like black communities in Africa, the medicine they give us, the birth control they give us, they're tainted. Mind you, this is just a conspiracy and this is based on the stories I've heard. But to hear the South African woman actually her uterus being taken out so that she doesn't conceive, please explain this to me logically. Let me understand it. I really want to understand it. If she went there to give birth and after she's done, why in the world would you take out her uterus? And those 40 plus women, why are they left without a uterus? It does not make sense to me. Even if they had HIV, why would they take out their uteruses? You know, you can have an, even if you have HIV, you can have a baby that does not have HIV. You just need to follow through with the things that the doctors advise you. And you can have a baby with no HIV, even if you and your husband have HIV. Isn't that what they tell us? Isn't that science? So why in the world are they taking out the uterus? And how come they're not taking responsibility? This lady didn't even receive a sorry. I am sorry. They have refused to acknowledge her pain. They have refused to say, I am sorry, we did something wrong. So that means they don't think they're doing something wrong. Like, it's really, really, really annoying. Like, this is our womanhood. You know, as a female, we would like to conceive someday. Yes, there are a few people, maybe they don't want to conceive, they don't want babies, to each his own. But at the end of the day, for a woman that wants to carry her child, she carried her child once, so they can't tell her it didn't happen there. She carried her child after 11 years because she didn't need to. She was even taking pills. She found out that she doesn't even have uterus. Like, how does that happen? Like, this is so sensitive, and as a woman, I understand it. I understand how much pain she must be going through. I've watched a documentary in the US. This happens in the US, in the black community. They'll go for something and they'll sterilize them and send them home. And when they're trying to conceive, it's not happening because they're sterilized. How is this right? How is this right? This is a violation of a human right. This is a violation of a womanhood. Like, how is this happening right now to our women? I don't find it hard to believe that they're capable of doing this. There are evil people that are capable of doing these things to us. They don't want our population just growing and growing and growing. And lucky for us, it's just us that are growing. Most population other than Africa, they're declining. We are growing. Our population is growing. Our youth is growing. Yes, that's a scary thought for evil people. This is so evil. I found this so disturbing that this woman and other women are going through this. And the most sad part is we turn to our doctors. We believe our doctors. We listen to them. They take an oath to take care of us. And yet they're the ones hurting us. And yet they take our trust for granted. And they take advantage of us. This is a crime. And I hope they pay for it. And I hope this clinic, this doctor, pays for their surrogates, takes the eggs, helps this woman have surrogates, help them have babies, and they need to be shut down. This is not a joke. This is not a simple, silly thing. They didn't just cut away this woman's hair. They took away her womanhood. And us as women, we need to stand up and say no. This is why we need our own youth studying medicine, taking care of us, taking care of their own women. As a woman, I feel really bad for this woman. And I know how a lot of women try so hard to conceive. Imagine how crushed they will be. It's not because they were incapable. It's because somebody did something to them. It's because of the pills they've been taking, because they were told by their doctor they trust. Is our government really checking the ingredients? Is what it is given in the West and here, is it the same? Is the ingredients the same? Are we really checking out the pharmaceutical companies? Do our governments really check that we're getting quality stuff? Are we getting the right stuff? Are we getting something temporary, or are they sterilizing us? Yeah, guys, this really got to me, so I really needed to come to you and vent. So you tell me down below in the comment section what your thoughts are. Tell me the stories you've heard, and if you've watched documentaries or if you have facts, please link them down below so that I check them out and I educate myself in this topic, please. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Stay blessed. Bye.